Here I have my T-square, a 30-60 triangle, and a piece of paper attached to my drawing board. To see more information about the T-square, triangles, and drawing board, please see the previous video on technical drawing tools. In order to draw an isometric cube, we need to learn how to use our T-square and triangle. The T-square can slide up and down on the drawing board, allowing us to draw parallel lines wherever we want. We can then slide a triangle to be able to draw vertical or perpendicular lines anywhere on the page. In addition, we can also use the triangle to draw 30-degree lines in either direction by flipping it over. We can move this to the position we want and slide it on the T-square. First, let's go ahead and draw a vertical line. This vertical line will be the front of our isometric cube. You want to draw it a little bit lower on the page. I'm going to draw mine about 60 millimeters long. You would draw your lines lightly, but I'm going to draw a rather dark line so you can see it on the video. Now I have my vertical line for my cube. The next thing to do is to take the triangle and move it to the bottom of the vertical line. Put your pencil at the bottom tip so you can draw a 30-degree angle with your triangle like this. Then go to the top and draw a line at the same 30 degrees. Now we have two parallel lines on the page. Then, flip the triangle over and draw from the bottom up the opposite 30 degrees. Slide the T-square up and the triangle up and draw again. Now we have the top and bottom of the two sides of the isometric cube. But wait, how do we find out where the side corners are? One way to do this is to extend these lines down. So we can go ahead and use the triangle to draw this line down, and this will be our corner. And then we can extend this line down, and this will be our other corner. You would draw these lines very light, and you only need to make a mark on the corner rather than drawing the whole line. Then we can draw vertical lines from both of these marks, and now you can start to see the two sides of our cube. Next, we can flip our triangle over and start at this mark. Draw across with the triangle at 30 degrees. And then here, you can draw the final line going the other direction. If you've drawn lightly, you can now go back in and darken your lines. You can draw all sets of lines that are parallel at the same time to make it easier for yourself. Then you can flip your triangles and finally draw the other angle. Now I have an isometric cube, and at this point I can go ahead and erase any stray marks. Of course, you would draw all these marks nice and light, but I've drawn them dark so you can see them. Good luck drawing your isometric cubes.